which define the action word in the sentence. Action word means, for example, he is singing a song. So in this sentence, from which word you are able to understand the action or the word? Singing. So singing is the example of verb. Is telling that tense. Okay, this happened in present. So this is helping verb. It is also called auxiliary verb, and this is called main verb. Understood this? Again, I will ask question from you. Verb. What is called verb? Verb is a word from which we are able to know the action word in the sentence. Okay, the word which explains the action in the sentence is called verb. Set up. Then you say me, what is called adverb? Tomorrow everyone will come with grammar book, okay? Yes? Yes?
So we have done.
Everyone is having?
No, sir.
Okay. Say? Those who are having, they can take out. Say?
The grammar book.
Yes, we are studying grammar only, no?
So we have to take out grammar.
No, don't take out. In the copy only write and learn what I am teaching. Book is present with you 24 hours.
Okay, sir.
But the teaching and concept you have to understand children in the class only. Okay. Example, now you see. I am saying he is tall. Right? He is a tall boy. Tall boy, you see two L are there, means very big height. Right. Now I am saying he is so tall boy. He is
so tall boy.
Means not tall. He is very tall. So tall. Okay. This word so is defining the adjective or qualifying the adjective. So this is called adverb. This is called
adverb.
I am saying she is beautiful. Beautiful is adjective. I'm saying she is so beautiful. Okay. Maybe I'm talking about my grandmother, right? So, what I'm saying, children, that adverb used to qualify, okay, adjective and other adverb, okay? Like this you learn. If you will learn all this concept, then only it will be easy for me to teach you writing section. Sit down. Saurav, if you promise me that you will behave normally in the class, you will focus on your studies, then I can allow you to sit, otherwise you have to stand. Yes sir, what? Yes sir. Say a full sentence at least. What is he saying? Yes sir, I want to go to that sir. Is murmuring something.
So he is shining.
He is?
Shining.
You don't speak in between. Okay, now what we will do? You all are asked to write all the definition how much you know. Okay, starting from noun to preposition with example in your own words. Everyone, this is your CW. Start doing this. Saurav, go to your place and do the work. Yes, online children? You all are online? And you all are also very good children, I hope. Few are saying no, sir. Okay, so you also start writing the things, okay? And after the class, you can send in group. Those who will send in group, I will understand you are writing. Those who will not send in the group, I will understand you are not writing.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Also it is good, in words also it is good. Are saying not to sit like this because you are crossing the leg.
No.
Have you remembered this?
No.
Okay. So the parents send you to school so that teachers can teach you these things. Online children, you also write.
Thank you.
which boy? Please stand up. Read what you have written.
Nouns are?
Can I teach you also in between children?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now I am giving you definition of noun. Right? So the definition of noun is very, very easy. How I used to teach, that used to be little bit different. My purpose is, if you have understood, then the work is done. If you are not able to remember and understand, then the work is not done. See, grammar is different from literature, yes or no? Grammar is different from literature, yes or no? Grammar used to be all parts of a speech, verb, tense. Literature, stories are written, poems are there. SST you study in English only, okay. Science you study in English only, right. So grammar is different and literature is different, okay. In English, whatever the word is coming under the list of name, whatever the word is coming in the list of grammar, Mr. Grammar, Mr. Literature, Mr. Literature. What is coming? Name for grammar, that is not name, that is noun. That is? Example, Africa. I will say Africa is the name. This is the name of a continent. Grammar will say no, no, Africa is noun. Africa is? I will say Rakesh. Rakesh is name in literature. Grammar is say no. Rakesh is noun. But when we are meeting with someone, we don't ask what is your noun. What is your
name?
We say what is your
name.
If you understand this concept, that whatever name is there in literature, that is only noun in grammar, then no question will be there which you cannot solve in the examination. This concept only you have to understand. And definition, simply you can write noun is the name of place, person or anything, etc. Okay? Example, Rakesh, Delhi, Taj Mahal, etc. But concept is this only. In grammar, the word name is not there. Name is not there only. And in literature, the word noun is not there. This is how, no? For example, someone name is Rahul. But in whom his name is Bittu. Understood? Like that here, name and noun. One more example, you see Ganga. And you see literature, Mr. Literature is here. He is Mr. Literature, and he is Mr. Grammar, right? So Mr. Literature, when he is reading something, he is saying that Ganga is name. Ganga is the name of a river. And Mr. Grammar is saying, no, my brother, Ganga is noun. Ganga is? So whatever he is saying is name, that he is saying is noun. And why we used to confuse? We used to confuse because grammar and literature, they both are essential part of English language. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Example, I am writing here Riya. And I am asking, Mr. Literature, what this word is? Mr. Literature can say, saying is?
Now.
Now. Have you understood this? Was it interesting? Okay. Now write your work which is there. So lesson 16 in English question answer you all have done? No.
No.
So today the homework will be that only, and you read this lesson when you are come. So homework is do question answer of lesson 14, that is, or lesson 16. CW, right? Yes, right?